things. So these are, when I do my baking, these all can feature into some extent. But let me just tell you the things now. When you get dark blackstrap molasses, even though it comes from sugar, this is just so chock-a-lock full of iron. And you really are not going to use very much, right? Like, think about it. Like, if you want to add some to this, well, you could add some to this. Let's see what it tastes like. You're not going to put very much, right? Because you know what it's going to do. It's going to overpower the whole flavor. And so you can use a little bit. And guess what? You're getting loads of iron, loads of minerals. So you want to, so you don't want to have very much of this in it. And I'm not really recommending that you use molasses on a big basis. But it's still, but you see how little I put in there. And that's really majorly sweet, right?
Yeah.
I could have had twice as much of that mixture in to put in that less than a quarter of a teaspoon of molasses. So I'm not promoting that you use a lot of molasses, because again, it is a sugar, but a little bit once in a while is something. If you're having you're just having one of those moments where you want something sweet, then it's not such a bad idea. Now, agave syrup has had this great big, especially organic raw agave syrup, has had this great big thing about how great it is, and it's the best thing in the world, but you know, the thing about it is it actually isn't. It's one of the things that raises the blood sugar the highest, fastest. Like, so for diabetics, this is a really bad choice. So if it's a really bad choice for diabetics, it makes you wonder, is it really such a good choice for the rest of us? You know? So, and I've had this bottle for quite a while. And I've done baking, and I've had this. I usually it's more if I'm making raw things. But I just don't highly recommend it anymore. I used to think it was a good idea, but now that I know that diabetics have a really hard time with it, and it just raises your blood sugar like really fast. So it's like every time there's new foods that come onto the market, there's always new fads, and people get all excited about this. This is the latest thing. Now, green smoothies have been a great big thing for the last 12 years or something, but you know, they really are a good healthy thing. I can't find anything wrong with that, you know. But something like this, like the whole raw food movement about how we should all just eat raw food all the time, I'm sorry, I don't believe it. You know, some people do seem to do quite well in it, but I don't really believe that it works for everybody. And that's why, and it's the same thing. So with the raw food movement came this raw agave, and everybody got so excited about it. But the research that's coming out about it now is not as positive. It's not like it's too very bad, but you don't want to do a lot of it. The other thing that I have really loved to use a lot has been this brown rice syrup. And one of the reasons why I like it is because it digests more slowly than other sugars. There has been a little bit of research lately about there maybe being some toxins that are getting into brown rice syrup, even if it's organic. So I don't know where to go with that exactly. So I'm just telling you what I'm thinking, okay? The one thing that I think is pretty safe is if you get an unpasteurized honey. It needs to be unpasteurized so that it's not all ripped up. But again, it's very, very sweet. And you really don't want too much of it.
How about the manuka honey?
That's good too. Yeah, that's good. You know, just remember, they're all sugars. It's just that white sugar is, you know, the worst thing that you can come across, really, because if you think about it, white sugar is just, there's apparently like rats have been, when they were fed it, and they had a choice between that and cocaine. They were all addicted to cocaine first, and then they were given sugar, and they got addicted to sugar, and they were addicted to both. They chose white sugar over cocaine.
Oh, I have a question.
Yeah.
I like having coffee in the morning with cream. But I'll put a Splenda in, and then I like it sweet, salt, and sugar. So what could be an alternative for sugar?
Why don't you try a little bit of honey instead? Because for you, because you've gotten used to those artificial sweeteners, unfortunately, you want to wean yourself off of them. And as much as I'd like to say that I'd love you to do the stevia, I know that you won't, because I know that you can't yet. You know, it could happen later, because the taste, I don't know what happens to taste buds of people that use the Bema. And I hope you don't mind me saying
that's
this,
because
I've noticed it. I've been noticing it for the last 10 years, and it's consistent. I have every single time I have found this to be the case, and I'm thinking it's really interesting. You know, I'd like to see some research done on it because it's kind of interesting. So I would think, you know, go for either of these two things, a little bit of one and the other. That would be better, and then try and get rid of that Splenda, because that Splenda. You know, when you're having some conversing with me or something over the internet, ask me to send you some stuff on it. It's, when you read all the research on it, you won't want to put that in your body. It's not good for you.
Okay. It's funny because I know it's like approved by the Canadian Diabetic Association. And,
well, you know, and I didn't bring those names. It's hard to remember when I'm used to doing things, cooking things in my home, so sometimes I forget little bits. But the stevia is made from the leaves and stems of a plant, and it really is a plant. And I actually I grow them in my yard, in my garden every year, and I can show you green leaves. If you ate that green leaf, it's really, really sweet. Yeah, and you got some stevia there.
Well, I'll tell you, this is how I know about the food combining is via Suzanne Summers, and she sells this thing that was supposed to be all natural. Not sure what's in there anymore, but
yeah, it doesn't say what it doesn't say.
I have it on the box that I have to bring.
Yeah, you have to see the box. Well, yeah, it'd be kind of interesting to see what was really in it. You know, sometimes some of the stevias they over process them. You know, like natural sugar that's not brown sugar. Do you know what brown sugar is?
Mm-hmm.
It's just
cane sugar.
Yeah, but it's not cane sugar. You know what it really is. They've taken white sugar and they've just mixed some molasses with it. That's all it is. But real natural cane sugar, before it becomes white sugar and before they make it into brown sugar, that is much more natural, right? Like that wouldn't be as bad to eat. That would be the next best thing to any of these, right? That would be better. But the white sugar is similar to making, when they make stevia, they make it out of this white powder. It's the same kind of thing. They're actually reducing it. They're almost like chemicalizing the stevia. Whereas this, what they've done is they've boiled it. They've taken the leaves, boiled the leaves until it becomes a liquid that's very, very sweet. So this is still pretty natural, because the same thing with maple syrup. They take it out of the tree. It's very, not very sweet. It's just like flavored, a little bit sweetened water. That's what it tastes like. They have to boil it until it becomes that syrup. So it's a similar kind of thing that's happening here. And so that's not so unhealthy. So that's what I think. So if you are getting a stevia, you have to make sure you're getting good variety. And there's a lot of stevias out there where they have them in, what do they call it? In alcohol, and I also don't agree with that. Like they use that as a preservative, and I don't like the alcohol in it myself.
I've seen that same way. Is that these little packets?
Could they try any of these so they can actually know what they taste like, so they know what they're buying?
Well, you know what honey tastes like.
And it does taste like, because some things when you buy them in a different form. Don't
but,
taste
but,
the same.
But honey, you understand.
And the honey actually does taste like honey.
Honey.
I bought some raw honey that does not taste like honey, though. I bought some manduka honey,
different. Okay, well, you can. I because you're all kind of being on this little dieting thing, I didn't know whether I should be giving you sugar.
Oh, they're not on a diet, right?
Okay, no,
they're not on a diet. I'm teaching them how to live a healthy lifestyle.
I didn't want
to try the brown.
Which is why you're here to teach them the hot list. The sexy.
Yummy recipes.
And it's less sweet.
Yeah, it is actually different.
And then I'll give you a little of this is the agave.
I love agave. Agave tastes sweet.
So how does agave compare to
Mrs. Brown's syrup, pancake syrup, or whoever is it.
Jemima and Jemima. Yeah,
well,
Jemima.
See all, well, what the, well, the problem with those is that they're made with sugar.
They're still made with
and
sugar.
And then they use artificial colors, mm-hmm. artificial flavors.
Okay.
Those you don't really want to use. If you're going to use it, I mean, I prefer maple syrup.
Yeah, we usually buy the maple syrup.
And, but real maple syrup, that's good. But you know what? I wouldn't even do that. If I was putting a syrup on mm-hmm. a pancake, I'd probably... see, now he does. He can get away with it because this is Mr. Skinny Guy here. Mm-hmm. but
yeah.
Well, what I would do is I make syrups where I put other things in it, juices and stuff, you know, and it just kind of makes it a little bit different.
Well, as a kid, we used to, well, I grew up with natural honey, and we would use honey with hot water, water it down, and then use that on.
Yeah.
I'm just thinking, no, I haven't done that for so long for myself, and I need to do my, well, guy prefers pancakes just alone without syrups. But he will be off time, and I'm going to get him to come eat
things. Yeah, so that's... Anyway, so that was kind of fun. You didn't taste it with the molasses in it, eh?
Oh, I will get my cup.
The guac is really nice.
Oh, great. Yeah, I've never been a fan of molasses, though.
All right. That was a mini sugar lesson.